I come from an adventuring on dinghy sailing background. I didn't do the Olympics, nor did my parents own yachts. In fact, my parents didn't even believe that there was a possibility for a career path in sailing. Despite this, I've spent 30 years as a professional sailor earning an income. The first 15 of those years, I was full-time. Latterly, I've earned probably 40% of my income through the sport. I started by teaching sailing. I did deliveries as much as I could around the place. I had my ocean yacht masters at the age of 20. And in those days, you had to navigate across the ocean using a sextant. At 23, I was running my own boat out in California, and I raced as much as I could. My racing pinnacled with four round-the-world race campaigns, the Whitbread, the Volvo, and Jules Verne, and I was a watch leader on all of those. In order to be a useful crew member, I guess I spent a lot of time learning engine maintenance, sail repair work, rigging, all that kind of thing. And I tried to get as much experience as possible by ending up going through the Southern Ocean three times in the space of 2 years, which was kind of crazy. I still race full-time on a boat. It's a 100-foot yacht down in the Mediterranean, where I'm the only woman on a predominantly all-male crew. So I guess I experienced what it's like to be in the coalface of the sport in the arena of the training platform. I'm really passionate about the sport. I'm passionate about sailing. I love being out in the ocean with the wind in your face and the waves blowing. I am concerned about the future of the sport, and I'm really fed up with being the only girl out there waving the flag of kind of what's right and what's not right. So my desire is to try and understand and encourage more women into the sport and see how we can move this forward. I think world sailing, and in fact the whole world of sailing, is not doing too bad on a dinghy level. I think the IOC have started the ball rolling by their 50-50 by 2020, and I think that we've set some good systems in place. But from where I sit and the type of sailing I do, it's got a long way to go. Out in Sardinia, Saint-Tropez, some of the regattas that I participate in, I'm the only girl on the boat. I'm one of the only girls in the fleet that actually pulls a piece of string. There's very few girls that are in roles of decision making. And it's kind of funny because you guys may think that the regattas that I'm at are not really that important. They're not world championships. They're not one design sailing. But this is the bread and butter sailing. This is the training ground for the guys that do the Volvo Ocean Race and the America's Cup. You know, it attracts the top level of male sailors. We have Neil MacDonald there. Ian Walker's been out there. He's been sailing with me for the last couple of years. Steve Hales navigates on one of the other Wallys. You know, Dean Barker was down there on Rambler. So it's attracting them because it's keeping their skill set sharp. It's keeping them current with timing. They're meeting other guys. They're seeing potential new crew members that might work for teams that they have coming up. So they're networking and they're trying new things, they're trying sail combinations, and they're constantly progressing the technology. So what I find sad is that a lot of the girls who have done the SCA team and who are in the Volvo now haven't had the opportunity that's open to the men to keep themselves current. In fact, some of those girls have actually had shore jobs in the America's Cup or office jobs. You know, and some of these girls that come from the Olympic pathway actually end up dropping out of the scene. So, you know, what can we do? And I hear a lot of you guys say, it wasn't given to me on a plate. You know, why should we make it so easy for the girls? But the trouble is that you guys have experienced not getting there more through will, not through prejudices or biases or trains of thought. So I'm going to tell you a story. Picture this. Imagine you're a guy, you own a boat, you've got regattas coming up and you're short of a spinnaker trimmer. And you've got a choice. You can take me on the boat or you can take Joe Bloggs. Joe Bloggs is of equal experience to me. You know, let's say he's even 5 years younger. You decide to take me. So your fellow skippers of boats kind of, wow, okay, why are you taking Emma? What's she look like? Is she any good? Your wife raises an eyebrow at the thought that you're going offshore and you've got a girl on the boat. And then the rest of the crew kind of question it, because what's my skill levels like? Am I adequate? Are they going to have to pick up the pieces for the areas that I'm not good enough at? You know, it's much easier to take Joe Bloggs because you don't have to justify your decision. You don't have to explain to your wife why you're taking a girl on the boat on an offshore race when you've never taken her or your daughter. So the problem is that the willingness to take girls on boats doesn't sort of dwindles away. And the experience level then between the girls and the boys just gets bigger. So here's another, let's look at it from another angle. I was in Saint-Tropez the other week and we're chatting in the bar. And one of the guys says to me, he's an America's Cup, current America's Cup sailor. We're talking about the Volvo race and Mark Turner. And he turns around to me and he says, wow, pretty good that Mark Turner's left the Volvo now. Maybe they'll change the rule and we'll get rid of that ridiculous thing about crew numbers and we won't have to have girls sailing in it. So I look at him, and I'm not kidding, my heart stops beating for a minute. And I think, crikey, it's 2017 and we're still having this conversation. You know, for 25 years, I hear this stuff. So I say to him, well, I think Mark had a, you know, fairly good reason for it. He's trying to create an opportunity at the top level of the sport, and experience will then come. We have a bit of a chat about that. And then he looks at me and says, I hate positive discrimination. It's you should be at the top level for your credibility. And I kind of get that, you know. I don't want to be sailing with people that aren't as good as what I think I am. It's kind of like we're creating the opportunity. We're selling family cars to women, but the women don't have any ovaries. They don't have any way of filling the family car because they haven't got the playground to gain the experience. So I look at him and I think, I am just not going to confront this right now. I'm in a bar, there's 100 guys in here. For me to stand there and start ranting, you know, they just jeer at me, they tease me, they wind me up. I just haven't got the energy for it. And so I stand back, because what ends up happening is I become abrasive, and then I make myself unpopular, and then I don't get offered a ride on another boat, and then I lose work. That's why I came to see Andy, and that's why I'm standing in front of you guys today. Because I can't take this on by myself. You know, Libby can't take it on by herself, and nor can any of these other girls. Team Magenta's made a really good start, but we need to do this together. And collectively, we need to change the willingness in the guys on the boats, change the willingness with the people bringing crew onto boats. We need to change the image of what a female sailor looks like. We need to embrace the differences. And we need to make a difference so that in the future, you know, my 10-year-old niece and some of your daughters doesn't have to deal with this biasness. They just get out there because they're good at it. So to summarise, I think World Sailing are doing a really good job at a dinghy level. I think that we do have a long way to go in the Yachting Forum, in the area of the build-up to the bigger around-the-world campaigns. We need to change willingness of people to have crew on their boats. We need to change the perception of what a female sailor means and looks like and how useful they are on a boat. And we need to close the gap of the experience levels between men and women. And we need to shut down, get the genders to be closer to each other and shut down the feeling that there is discrimination on either side. World Sailing need to set an example. We need more women in the sport for the longevity of the sport. We need more women in management roles. We need more female athletes. In order to encourage people into the sport, we need to show them that there's a career path. So I think we need to acknowledge and recognise and embellish on those sailors or those women that have made a career successfully out of sailing. And I think that will show that there is a possibility in order to make a living, and it will encourage families to believe that sailing is a good option for a career path. World Sailing has actually embraced, the gender equality issue in their committees. They've said on their regulations that they need to have a 25% representation from each gender. However, how many of you who are actually on committees can say that you have 25%? I'll tell you right now, none of you can, because if you look through the numbers, there's 20% on some of them, and I think there's 11 on some of them as well. So the average is 18. You know, 25 to 75, I mean, equality is 50-50. We haven't even got that, you know. We've got 18 and 82. It's ridiculous. So this last lot of voting that you guys did, you know, how come that was allowed to stand? It doesn't show a great respect for the intent of the regulation of trying to encourage more people, more women into the committees. So I know this isn't actually a world sailing problem because these committees have voted. So it's actually the nominations from the national bodies. So the national bodies, maybe they should be restricted that if they've only got seven girls to put forward, they can only put seven guys forward. So then there is a bigger pool of women to vote from. How do you guys go about scouting for, you know, for women? Do you actually actively go out to look and encourage? You know, I'm nearly 50 and nobody's come anywhere near me. I've gone around the world four times. I still sell professionally. I only found out about the option to go and be on committees through having a friend of mine to stay. But there's been, I think, five now all-female campaigns in the Volvo race. You know, there's five skippers. There's 250 girls that have been involved in that race. How many of you national bodies have actually gone to any of those people and suggested that they come forward and they sort of make a stance in the sport? So to summarise, I think World Sailing needs to sort out their in-house problems. They need to set an example before they can get into the sport and start telling people how what sort of crew they can have on their boats. But then we need to work out how to set a career path for women through these, you know, private yacht scene. And I think we need to do that through using role models and through encouraging owners to patron certain things in the sport. And then we will be creating a decent, you know, we'll be creating a career path where girls can come into and they don't have to be Olympians or Volvo sailors. People should care because it will affect us all. The future of the sport really is at risk without attracting everybody. You know, the world at the moment is recognising the need for gender equality. The world at the moment is recognising a need for diversity and equality throughout for all minorities. Currently, our sport is not diverse. It doesn't represent everyone. It represents about 30% of the world population. You know, the white, Anglo-Saxonized male. It's crazy. You know, if we're not careful, the Olympics have put these stipulations in. And if we're not careful, the sport will fall out of the Olympic Games. You know, at worst, at best, we get a reduction in the number of classes. And none of you need me to explain what a financial implication that will have on the whole sport. And not just about money, it's about who it attracts into the sport and the professionalism, which then rubs off through all other areas of the sport. So let's say we're not really that bothered by Olympic funding because we can get funding from other places. You know, can we? Have you guys got any idea how difficult it is to get sponsorship? You know, I tried for the Volvo race. It's really difficult because it is not a sport that represents the whole world. You know, let's look at the Volvo. Volvo themselves sponsor a race, but they financially support many of the boats in that race as well because it doesn't tick enough boxes. There is an independent yacht forum, which I'm sure many of you guys are aware of. It runs independently to World Sailing. I got an email through about that the other day with a list of some of the presenters. You know, I went on the website. There's 52 presenters in that. 46 are white, anglicised, you know, European, American-y, Australian-y men between the age of, I think, 45 and 60. There's six women. You know, there's way more women that are actually doing things in the sport. You just have to go out and look for them. So currently, the problem is that sailing doesn't represent the world, and we're missing out at the moment on 50% of it because we're not attracting women. To summarise, I really care about sailing. I love it. I've made an income and had a career in sailing for 30 years, like I keep saying. You know, but the sport in general is in decline because there's too many options out there. So the sport of sailing is definitely in decline. You know, World Sailing represents the whole of sailing. It is the international body of sailing. It's not World Dinghy Sailing, it's World Sailing. So it has a critical role to play in this situation of creating a pathway and embellishing the different attributes that women bring to teams. Without having them as negatives, they need to be positives. You know, we need to set an example in our sport. But all of you have a critical role to play as well. You know, ask yourselves, when you think of crew members to bring onto your boat, do you bias against women? You know, and if you're on a committee, have you got 25 representation of females on your committees? So a final question, are we making sailing attractive to everybody in order to keep the sport popular and current? If world sailing doesn't set an example, then who is going to set an example? And given that we really haven't seen much change in 25 years of my experience, to coin a phrase from Emma Watson's He for She, if we don't start doing something now, then when are we going to do something?